Don't forget your proficiencies. Combat proficiencies. Hey guys, Avi here. So we all started Star Wars The Old Republic somewhere in our gaming journey, and I thought it could be a fun idea to mention 5 common mistakes that beginners make in Star Wars The Old Republic. Number 1 on the list will be skipping the main storyline cutscenes. With the main storyline, once you skip a story, and just completely skip, you cannot go back. If you missed something, you missed a crucial part, you either have to go to YouTube, look it up somewhere else, because you cannot go back into the story and redo it. And then on to the next mistake. Well, is it really a mistake? You gotta read the tutorial tips, guys. They are there for a reason. I've seen so many people, myself included at times, that I just completely skip over the tutorials that just flash in your screen. And guys, they are there for a reason. Spoken about reading things well, it is really important when making a class to know what type of class you pick. When I started playing Star Wars The Old Republic, I actually started off as a Shadow, which is a double-bladed lightsaber, and I was playing as a DPS. And as you guys know, a Shadow, you are either a tank or a DPS. And I thought, okay, this is really cool. It has like a double-bladed lightsaber. However, I also wanted to heal. And I did not read anything on the internet about it, I actually had to pick a sage if I wanted to heal. So that's a tiny little mistake that I made, and I've seen so many other players make as well. So yeah, make sure you read well before picking a class and know what you're getting into. And while we are speaking about classes, it is very important to also set your combat proficiencies in the game together with actually visiting your trainer once you level up, because you want to have your skills right, you level up, and you don't want to run around like all game long with barely having anything learned. And it's a tiny little mistake. It's a mistake. It's easily made way into the story and you level up really fast. You just skip it. Visit your trainer, guys, and don't forget your proficiencies. Combat proficiencies. There, now I said it correctly. And the last mistake that I see lots of people make is with the user interface. When you start off playing Star Wars The Old Republic, you only have one ability bar, but did you know that you can also expand it to more and multiple ability bars? You will need them. That's all I can say, you will need them, especially after level 10, you get so many abilities, it just doesn't fit on one bar. So don't forget that, guys. And this is actually more of a bonus mistake that I see some people make, but when you run around and you speak to an NPC and you pick up a flashpoint quest, pick them solo, because I have seen people running into a veteran flashpoint with just their companion. There are solo story flashpoints for that. Most of the time, especially if you're just leveling and just trying to the story, you won't make it to the flashpoint. So guys, no, if you're doing the story, pick story mode, otherwise you're not gonna make it. Those were the 5 most made. Is it even a word? I hope you're not going to make those mistakes when you're starting on your Star Wars The Old Republic journey. I don't know what to say. I terribly suck at ending videos. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to smash that like and subscribe button if you've not already, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye.